Hi, this is Suzanne from Holiday Travel. Today on Travel Talk, we have Mark Taraborelli from Disney Destinations, and today's theme is Disney Cruise. Welcome, Mark.
Hi, Suzanne. Great to be here.
Yes. So everybody knows Disney for their parks.
Yep.
Disney Cruise, it's been around how many years? When did it start?
Disney Cruise Line began in 1998.
Wow, so we're almost 20 years.
Yeah.
Almost, yeah.
With the Disney Magic was our, the first ship, and then 1999 we came out with the sister ship to the Magic, which is the Wonder.
Yeah.
And Disney got into the cruise business because those who remember way back when, we had our characters. We were part of Big Red Boat.
I remember
When it was part of Premier Cruise Lines.
Yep.
And we found a need to actually go into the cruise line business because at that time we didn't have really control over the ships, the quality of the ships, the crew members on board. So we wanted to really create something where it was truly Disney and wholly Disney owned and operated. Mm-hmm. So that's when Disney Cruise Line came out, which was in the late 1990s.
Wow.
And now we have four ships in our fleet.
Yeah.
So there's the Magic, the Wonder, the Dream, and the Fantasy.
Yep.
The Dream and the Fantasy are the newer ships.
Yep.
They're larger than the Magic and the Wonder. They're three decks taller, 4,000 passengers versus about 2,500.
Okay.
And then we also have two more ships on the horizon.
You're expecting, huh?
Yep.
Twins?
Yeah, well, we'll see. We don't know what their names are going to be yet.
Okay.
We don't know what they're going to, but it was announced that we are going to have two more ships added to our fleet, so we will have six ships.
Target date? Have they given a target date?
We have not, so don't know yet. It's a few years down the road, 4 years or so, more to come with that.
Yeah, good, good. So a little bit different amenities, different options on Disney cruise ships versus a regular cruise ship, if there is such a thing as a regular cruise ship. One of my favorites is the split bathrooms that are in the cabins, especially for families traveling, even for a couple traveling.
Yeah, we have, I think one of the questions I get a lot from people is, you know, what makes a Disney Cruise Line experience different from other cruise lines?
Yeah.
And if you think about it, Disney is not a cruise line company.
Right.
We are an entertainment company that got into the cruise line business. So you take what our parks and our resorts are known for at Walt Disney World, at Disneyland, all of our parks around the world. You take what we're known for, the quality of entertainment, the attention to detail, the theming, the storytelling, and you weave that into a ship concept. And that's what Disney Cruise Line is all about.
Yeah.
So if you walk onto any one of our ships and you were to walk on blindfolded and somebody took off the blindfold, you would realize
you would know
you were on a Disney ship just because that theming and that storytelling is carried throughout. Whereas other cruise lines, they do a great job.
Yeah.
But if you were to be on Cruise Line A versus Cruise Line B and do the same thing, you're not going to really know the difference from one to another.
Yeah.
So that's the first overarching difference right there is that attention to detail and that theming and the storytelling and just how an entertainment company operates in the cruise line business. And then when it comes to things on the ship, the noticeable differences. So again, we have to cater to families.
Right.
Not that families are the only ones who travel on a Disney cruise line. Actually, close to 37-40% of the guests that travel with us travel without any kids. So that's an interesting statistic. Yeah. A lot of people don't know that.
Yeah.
So you don't have to have kids to enjoy a Disney cruise line experience. Same thing with our parks and resorts. There's something for all different age ranges.
Yeah.
So with Disney Cruise Line, we've done a great job at providing different club areas for the kids.
Okay.
So whether it's you're in that 4 to 11 age range, so there's the Oceaneers Club for that age range. The 11 to 13 for the tweens, as we call them. There's the Oceaneers. There's the Oceaneers Club, the Oceaneers, the Edge. I'm sorry, the Edge and the Vibe for the teens and the tweens in that age range. So so something for the 11 to 13, and then the 14 to 17 age range. So who better than Disney to keep kids occupied in their own club areas while the adults are off, you know, doing their own thing in the adults. There's the adults only pool area, which is the Quiet Cove pool. We have adult only nightclub areas. Each club has its own nightlife district with different themed nightclubs, as well as adult only specialty restaurants as well. And then the staterooms, getting back to what you were asking about the split bath concept, again, because we cater to families, there are many staterooms that have to accommodate, you know, four or five people in a stateroom. So if you think about it, when you're coming back from an excursion or coming back from the pool or the beach, and you need to get ready for a meal, for dinner, if you just had one bathroom, how would everybody you know, do that? That would make it challenging. So the split bath concept, there's actually two bathrooms. One side has a sink and a toilet. The other side has a sink, tub, and shower. So somebody can be getting ready in one while somebody else is in another. So for efficiency's sake, it works out great.
It's fabulous, yes. You touched briefly on the excursions, the dining, but my favorite out of everything with Disney is Castaway Key.
Yeah, that's our crown jewel. The Bahamian and the Caribbean itineraries, we make a stop with most of the Caribbean itineraries. We make a stop at Castaway Key. So that's our private island in the Bahamas. And since we own the island, we are the only ship to go there. And there's only one Disney ship at a time that goes there. And we dock there. We don't tender. So that means you're right at the
You walk
the pier,
right off the boat.
And you walk right off and you're on the island. And just like the ship itself, there's activities for different age ranges. It even has Serenity Bay, which is an adult-only beach area. And there's cabanas there, so you can do like a massage, a cabana massage there. So it's very relaxing. It's absolutely
very quiet. It's gorgeous, just looking out over the blue water.
And then our the crew members on the ship come off and they prepare this phenomenal barbecue lunch on the island. So regardless of where you are, whether it's the adult-only beach area, Serenity Bay, or Scuttles Cove where the kids are, or the family areas, they set up this phenomenal lunch
For the guests. And it's free. I mean, it's included. It's not as if you got to pay for pay for anything.
It's all included,
The drinks on the island, you can get alcoholic drinks if you want. The soda is free, complimentary, as it is on board the ship.
Right, and that's another Disney difference there, too. All of our non-alcoholic beverages, sodas, juices, are complimentary on the ship and throughout throughout the cruise at the on the island, like you mentioned, on Castaway Key. Alcoholic beverages are obviously. Extra. You would have to pay for those. But we are one of the few cruise lines that offer non-alcoholic beverages because many other cruise lines you would have to get like a drink card. So when you start adding up, you know, again, people might think when they initially price out a Disney cruise, with you going through you as a travel agent, they might think, oh, gee, a Disney cruise is expensive. But when you start adding up the value of what you get for your Disney cruise experience, you see that you're getting a return on that on that vacation investment. So it's just really, you know, remarkable. The dining experiences themselves are part of the entertainment of the ship.
And just to touch back on the soda, so there's a huge soda area, I guess, for lack of better, right on near the pool deck. It's open 24/7.
Right.
So if you're up at 7 a.m. and you need a Diet Coke, you can go get one. Or if you're up at midnight and you're looking for something, a cup of coffee or a cup of tea or something, you can go get it.
There.
It doesn't matter what the hours. You don't have to wait for someone to bring it to you.
It's there 24/7.
So the kids aren't bugging your mom. Can we get a soda? Yeah, it's just go get
it's
it.
It's easy to get it there.
And as right around the pool area, there's other restaurants. There's a pizza.
Yeah, there's like grab-and-go type things, and a variety from healthy options like wraps and salads and fruit. Yep. There's also soft serve ice cream. There's pizzas, hot dogs, and that's all
complimentary.
It's all included as well.
Yeah.
And then we have three main restaurants on all of our ships.
Okay.
And like I was starting to mention earlier, that's like an entertainment experience themselves.
Yeah.
We have what's known as rotational dining.
Okay.
So that's where the server and the staff go with you from one restaurant to the next each day. So they get to know your tastes and preferences.
Right.
So
if
you have any dietary restrictions or dietary needs, you don't have to repeat yourself
every night
every
to
meal.
A different waiter. Yeah.
Right. So you just tell your server from the start of your cruise and they cater to your needs throughout the rest of the cruise.
Yeah, that's fabulous.
So they really get to become part of your family.
Yeah.
And they're like entertainers themselves.
Exactly.
They're great with the kids. They'll do things like napkin folding and make hats for the kids. And I mean, so they really really get into their you know, their roles.
Yeah, and they really do get to know you. I had a customer actually that had started the Atkins diet couple weeks before he went on, and he's thinking, oh, this is going to be tough. But he told his waiter the first night, I don't want any bread on the table. Mm-hmm. And the waiter would suggest different options for him, you know, like obviously keep away from the starches.
Right.
And they worked with him.
Yeah.
And he was happy. He came home, he lost 5 pounds.
Yeah.
You know, most of us gain
five
or 10 pounds.
Yeah.
But he was so happy that he was able to continue it on board because they just worked with them.
Yeah.
No, they work with if you got diabetic, celiac, if you're gluten-free.
Right.
They're fabulous.
Yeah. No, they do a really great job. So, and what they'll do is they'll even give you the menu for the next day to look at.
Yep.
So if somebody has any dietary restrictions, you can look and see what you're interested in ordering, and then they make note with the chef and the cooks, and then they'll prepare it accordingly for the next day.
Yeah. It's like having your own personal chef.
It is. It is. It's really, they
you get
do
spoiled.
An amazing job.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the three different main dining areas, we've got Animator's Palette, which is my all-time favorite.
Yeah, Animator's Palette is our staple on all four of our ships, and it varies from one ship to the next.
Yeah.
It's all themed around being an animator or animation.
Yeah.
The magic and the wonder, for instance, everything is in black and white, and then throughout the course of your meal, things transform into color.
Yeah.
And then the dream and the fantasy take on a little different theming with it. So it's still Animator's Palette, but it might be where you have a placemat in front of you and you draw a character on the placemat, or a stick figure, depending on how artistic you are, and then the servers gather them up, and then the finale at dessert is whatever you drew, and whatever the other guests around you at your table and throughout the dining room drew, they come to life on the screens around the perimeter of the restaurant,
on the walls,
and you get to see that as the show at the end of dinner.
Yeah.
Whatever you drew is coming to life and dancing with the Disney characters on the screens.
Yeah.
So there's that, and then we also have themed around Finding Nemo. We have the Turtle Crush that will come out and talk to guests in real time at their table.
Yeah.
So he swims down, so he's an animated, the turtle, Crush Turtle is animated, and he swims down, and it's all the screens that are around the perimeter of the restaurant.
Right, yeah.
So he'll come down, and then he'll talk to guests at their table. And so it's like you're talking to this animated
And he gets, he'll say, hey, you know, what's your name? Hey, you in the blue, what's
your
name?
Right, it's all
a
real
conversation.
What did
you do today? What did you, it's all,
it's,
and the kids are just looking like, how does this turtle talk?
No,
and how does he know, you know, that I've got plate of spaghetti in front of me?
Right,
So Disney magic.
Exactly, it's a lot of fun. People really get into that too.
Yeah.
So that's Animator's Palette. And the other two restaurants, one is, tends to be a little bit more formal or have a regal feel to it, whether it be the Royal Palace or the Royal Court or Lumiere's or Triton's. Those are the four for each of the ships.
Yeah.
And it tends to be a little bit more of the formal restaurants. And then the third restaurant is tends to be kind of in between. It's a little bit more casual, but also a little bit more in true Disney fashion. It can be a little bit more whimsical to it too.
And when you say formal, it's, you don't bring the tuxes and the tiaras. You don't need
Any of that. On our longer on a 7-day cruise, we will have a formal night, but it's optional if you wanted to do you know, wear a tuxedo, or ladies wear a gown, or you don't have to on any of the other nights dress.
You're not going
to
get kicked out of the dining room.
No. Yeah. I mean, there are dress code requirements for dinner, obviously.
Is it just collared shirts?
Yeah, right.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah. And then you have the adult-only dining on each of the ships?
Yep. On the Magic and the Wonder, we have Palos, which is a northern Italian-themed restaurant. And on the Dream and the Fantasy, because those are larger ships, we have both Palos and Remy.
Okay.
And Remy is a French-inspired restaurant, which is spectacular. It's a three-and-a-half-hour dining experience.
Yeah.
It's similar to if those who know Victoria and Albert's at the Grand Floridian.
Yeah.
So it's similar to that type of dining experience. Everything in that restaurant, from the china to the linens, was all custom made and designed for the restaurant.
And there's a small upcharge for each of those restaurants?
Correct. There's a surcharge for each of those restaurants. And it really is to cater for the needs of the staff that's in those restaurants, because they're not part of the regular dining rotation.
Okay,
so they're a special staff that works in those restaurants. And again, it's adult only. So children do not dine in those restaurants.
Yes, that's great. So another little difference in the staterooms on the newer Disney cruise ships versus the other is the magical porthole.
Yeah, the inside staterooms on the Dream and the Fantasy have magical portholes.
Okay.
That's where we have four cameras positioned around the ships.
Yep.
And they project images in real time on your inside stateroom porthole.
Okay.
So above the bed, where there would normally be like a mirror we have an actual porthole, so you can see what's going on outside at any given time, what the weather's like, and
where
are you, you know, if you're out at sea, if you're docked. And in true Disney fashion, there might be like a scuba Mickey character that swims by, or some Disney character that's incorporated into that. And if you have small kids during the day, if they're napping and you want to shut that off, you can turn that off.
Okay, yeah.
So it's a, guests love it.
Yeah.
I mean, those staterooms tend to sell, you know, book up very quickly because of some of those features.
And is it every inside cabin on the two new ships?
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The entertainment on board, let's talk about our Broadway shows, the movie theater.
Broadway-style entertainment, we have the Buena Vista Theater and the Walt Disney Theater on all of our ships.
Yep.
The Buena Vista Theater is where we will air the Disney movies and even first-run movies before the movies even make it to the theater.
Yeah.
If you're on a Disney cruise, you'll be lucky enough to see them before everyone, because we own them and we can do that. And many of them are even in 3D.
Okay.
So that puts an added touch to it.
Yeah.
And the Walt Disney Theater is where we put on our live stage shows in the evenings. And those are Broadway style shows, whether they're themed around the Golden Mickeys or Tangled or Frozen, or there's a whole variety of Broadway style shows that we do in that theater that are absolutely out of this world. It is, you know, one of the Disney differences why people choose Disney Cruise Line. And we'll have two shows every evening.
Yep.
So they're kind of dependent on your dining time. If you have an early dining time, then you go to the later show.
Yeah.
Or if you have a later seating, then you go to the early show. So that's how we stagger that.
Yeah.
So everybody gets a great seat in the house.
Yeah.
Everybody gets to experience the shows.
Right.
And it's truly something to look forward to.
Yeah. Now, you touched on briefly before the different areas for the kids. So the kids have pretty much one whole deck with all the clubs and everything. So unless you're an adult that has kids, you don't really need to go on that deck. So you don't see the kids as much as you do.
Right. Well, especially on like the Dream and the Fantasy, the teens in that 13 to 17 age range, they have their own outdoor deck space.
Yep.
So their area is exclusive just for them.
Yeah.
And the club areas, obviously the parents can go in and maybe check on their kids or check them in.
Yeah.
But the youth counselors are the ones that put together the activities and oversee all the activities and the kids in those areas. And they do an amazing job.
Yeah.
They really, I hear all the time from parents who brought kids there that will say, I had a hard time getting my kids out
of
the club areas.
That's the complaint I get. Yeah, exactly.
To get them to dinner or even to see the show at night.
Yeah.
They're like, that's,
to go to bed.
Right.
Yeah.
That's like a number, if you want to call it a complaint,
that's
like the number one thing that people will say. Like, my kids didn't want to leave those club areas. They do such a good job. And that's why adults have a great time, too, because they know their kids are taken care of in a very safe and secure environment where there's a lot of activities that are geared to their age range. And the adults can go off on their own and they'll say, I hardly saw any kids throughout the day on the ship because that's where they were.
Yeah.
So who better than Disney to cater to the kids while the adults are off enjoying their own their own time.
Yeah. So when you check your kid in or your child in, you get is it a beeper or something? If there's a problem with the child, then they can get in touch with you?
Yeah, correct. And then there's also, we have the other benefit in the staterooms. We have the wave phones.
Okay. Yep.
So there's two phones in there. So somebody can get one of the phones and then the adult can have another phone or two of the adults can each get a phone.
Yeah.
So if you want to know where somebody is at any given time, you can call them on that phone so that you know where they are on the ship to meet up with them or to find them. So that is, one way to communicate.
Yeah.
We also have the Disney Cruise Line app.
Okay.
That guests can download, and they also get the navigator, which is on there on that app too.
Okay.
So that's your own personal navigator to know what's going on that day.
Yeah.
We do a printed copy that is put on your inside or inside of your stateroom during your turndown service every evening, and that will be the navigator for the next day. But it's also available on your mobile device.
Yeah.
So, and you don't need to purchase the Wi-Fi in order to get that.
Yeah.
So that is, complimentary to have that that app downloaded onto your phone.
Yeah. The pools on board, you talked briefly about the adult-only area. There's the children's pool with the Mickey slide.
Yep, there's always a main family pool.
Yeah.
And then there is the Quiet Cove pool that is... that is for the adults only. The Dream and the Fantasy have the Aqua Duck.
Yeah.
So that is a water slide feature where you're riding on a flotation device.
Yeah.
And it is a lot of fun. I mean, I've got the times that I've gone on it, I just keep riding it over and over again. It is a lot of fun.
It's a clear tube, right? And don't you go out over the...
You go out over the edge of the ship and back in, and it's a clear... you're riding through this clear tube along, on the inner tube device. So it is, it's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And then on the Magic, we have the Aqua Dunk, which is a variation of the slide, but it's where you're standing straight up, you're standing vertically, and the floor drops out from under you, and you just go down the slide that way, and into the pool. So it's a lot of great enhancements that we've done on our ships.
So let's talk, where do we go? Where does Disney Cruise Line go?
We touch a lot of different parts, a lot of different places. So we cruise year-round out of Port Canaveral in Florida, which is only about an hour from Orlando.
Okay.
So you can add on the transfers if you like that way.
Yeah.
We have cruised out of Miami. We've cruised out of, and those itineraries out of Florida will do Bahamian and East-West Caribbean as well as Southern Caribbean itineraries.
Yeah.
We do have the Wonder that sails out of Vancouver and does Alaska during the summer between the May to early September timeframe.
Yeah.
And then when the Wonder is sailing Alaska, then its sister ship, the Magic, is in Europe.
Okay.
And it's doing sailings. It's doing Mediterranean, Northern Europe sailings. And we have opened up sailings currently through 2018.
Okay.
So there's a lot of, options. We hit a lot of different parts there. We've sailed out of New York before doing the New England coastal cruises up to Canada as well as down to the Bahamas.
Yeah.
And Galveston, too. We've sailed out of Galveston. Yeah. So you just... Best thing to do is get with a travel agent such as yourself to plan your Disney cruise. What's smart is to book early because with only four ships, it's supply and demand.
Yeah.
So the earlier you book, the better the inventory will be and probably the better
the
rate
prices
will be too.
Yeah.
So as that inventory sells out, So that will affect prices. Yeah. So that's the trick there.
Yeah, fabulous. Mm-hmm. People quite often will do a cruise land vacation, especially out of Florida. They'll do some days in the park and then go on the cruise.
Yeah, you can do a land-sea combination. Mm-hmm. Yep. I always recommend doing the land portion first.
Yep.
Because when you're at Walt Disney World, if you think about it, it's go, go, go.
Go.
You're waiting
in the lines yeah.
and the crowds. And
yeah.
Whereas then you can finish up on a Disney cruise and wind down and relax with the Disney cruise experience.
Exactly, yeah.
So that's my recommendation there. And you could always do like a three-day land, 3 or 4 day land, and a 3 or 4 day cruise. The Dream does the shorter, the 3, 4, 5 day Bahamian itineraries. And then the other ships will do longer sailings.
Yeah.
So if you've never sailed before or if you've never done a Disney cruise before and you want to get a flavor of what
just
it's like,
taste, yeah.
then maybe just, you know, start out with one of the shorter itineraries on the Disney Dream.
Yeah.
And then once the cruise is over, you'll say, I should have booked a 7 day. You have the option to do that on board. There's a lot of really great booking incentives to rebook a future cruise on board. On board your existing cruise. So definitely take advantage of those options.
And if you do the parks first and then the cruise, Disney will pick you up at the parks or at your hotel
Take you. The transportation can all be intertwined. So with Disney's Magical Express, you'll get the transfers from the airport to your hotel.
Yeah.
You will have to pay a nominal fee to do the transfer from the hotel to the pier, and then from the pier back to the airport after the cruise.
Or back to the parks if you want to go back and spend more time there.
Correct.
So besides the two new ships coming out, anything else new and exciting with Disney Cruise that's...
Well, I always say give it... people should, if like I said, if you've never cruised before, definitely give Disney Cruise an opportunity, you know, to be... You know, your cruise option,
right? Yeah.
So that once you sail, you'll see all of those experiences, what you get, the value for your money, Castaway Key. You know, and there's
always excursions on Castaway Key, isn't there?
There's excursions. All of our ports of call, we have excursions that you can purchase.
Yeah.
So whether it be parasailing, scuba diving, snorkeling, those types of experiences, or if it's excursions, if you don't want to do the water activities, you could do things like city tours.
Okay.
If you're in Nassau, Bahamas and want to do a tour of the town.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot of different, add-on excursions like that you can do. So always something new and exciting happening with Disney Cruise Line.
Yeah. I'm surprised that when you said that it was 30 to 40% adults only. I've been on all the ships a couple of times, and only once have I brought a child with me. So I've experienced the adult only, and it's great.
It is. I mean, you really can live the experience through the eyes of the children that are on board that ship. Obviously, you'll see, you know, kids and families during the dinner and the shows, but throughout the rest of the ship, it's just...
And the characters, we didn't even talk about the characters. They're not in your face, they're there.
Nope, and then there's tons of character experiences, meet and greet opportunities, and unlike the theme parks where you might have to wait in long lines...
Yeah.
The character experiences on board make it very seamless and easy to see the characters quite quickly.
Yeah, and dress up Halloween. They have different events. You can the Halloween dress up Christmas. It's all
just
decorated.
Like, just like our theme parks, we have the special events where we have Halloween on the high seas and the maritime cruises that we do during Christmas and the holidays.
Yeah.
So always something something happening with those events.
So we could talk forever again about Disney Cruise.
Yeah, we didn't even touch on the Star Wars days at sea and the Marvel's day at sea.
Yeah.
And I mean, there's even those for those affinity Star Wars and Marvel fans.
Yeah.
So a lot happening with Disney Cruise.
Thank you so much, Mark. I appreciate you stopping in today. Mark has been talking to us about Disney Cruise Line. I'm Suzanne from Holiday Travel, and you've been watching Travel Talk. Thank you.